There is a common problem in small businesses, and the problem is how to deal with new leads that coming in. Most of the leads will be okay because you are able to talk to them, but what happens when you're calling someone and he's not answering? Then you will need to start to set maybe reminders in your calendar, maybe you just try to remember to call the person again. But that is not really how things are supposed to work, and the results are very poor. Now, what about if one of my employees is marking the lead as a junk lead, which means no one will ever contact this lead, when the lead is not junk, when it's a good lead? Okay, so supposed to be a good, solid process, because those leads eventually cost us money. So let's see what Zoho are offering us. So Zoho came up with a module named Blueprint, and the blueprint is amazing. So lead nurturing process is an existing blueprint that coming out of the box from Zoho. Let's try to analyze it. So in the beginning, a lead will come in, and then we're supposed to gather some details. While we're gathering the details, you can see that we're supposed to ask few details if they are not available. For example, the email, the phone number and city, because without those information, we can't do much. Maybe the gathering information will be from an email, maybe it will be from a research, maybe even trying to contact the person using one of them. Maybe we have the email, but we don't have the phone or city. So we need to gather all the contact information. Once we're trying to contact, there will be two options. One, that we are able to contact, and then we're going all the way to establish contact. Or from the other side, we're not able to contact, and then the system will go to attempt to contact and will try to remind us using tasks. So there will be a task for me to try and connect. Yes. Try to connect with the client, with the lead. So as you can see here, there is an existing task that's supposed to remind me to contact the lead again. Task to reattempt and dollar leads last name, which means contact the person. Whenever we are able to contact, there can be three different options. I identified that the lead is junk, which means I'm selling Zoho customization services, but this person needs a new website. So of course I cannot help him and he's becoming a junk lead because there is no intention to buy my specific services. From the other side, I did talk to him and he was pre-qualified. So in that point, once he is pre-qualified, I will probably convert him to a contact and try to offer him one of my services. From the other side, maybe I tried to sell him my services, but it was too expensive, we had no personal connection, something happened, and then the lead became a lost lead. The person have intention to buy services from me, but from the other side, I was not able to convert him. Now, in that case, in the future, I will absolutely continue to try and convert him, and I will continue and send him value emails just to make sure that in the future I will be able to convert him. And I can tell you from experience, about 20-30% of those lost leads are coming back and becoming clients. Let's see how this specific blueprint works in real life. So I'm getting now a new lead. Let's see which one is a new lead. This is a new lead. Now I know it's a new lead because there is no status. The lead status is empty. I will click on him. And as you can see here, I have only one transition and it's gather details. Now the reason is that if you remember in the gather details, we have three things that the system required from us: email, phone, and there was one more, city. Now, probably one of them is missing. Now, phone, I know for sure it's missing. but probably also city, because I didn't punch in anything. Yes, so city is also empty. If I will click on get details, I will have the email address that is already in the system. I will need to punch in the phone number, and I will need to enter the city. Once I did that, I will need to try to contact the person. And there will be only two options for that. One, there was no answer. And if there was no answer, a task is being assigned to me to try to contact the customer tomorrow. If I tried again and there was no answer, because I tried again, reattempt, then again I'm getting the same thing, but it's starting to count down that it will be no more than three attempts, because I don't want to bug the person too much, and I will have my comments, try to call Mr. Brown. Okay, so now as you can see, I have here the reattempt. I have the first one, this is the second one, and also I entered the note. It was a mandatory note, and now it's added to the system. So let's assume that now I was able to establish connection, and now the system is requiring me to enter more details, because those details are the ones that the business wants me to enter. It can be anything. It can be any kind of detail that you like. But that's really the idea of a blueprint. The blueprint is supposed to keep me, whatever, you know, whatever my state is, let's say I'm angry, I'm busy, it doesn't really matter where I am as a person, as a human being. It doesn't matter what kind of education I have. I must follow the blueprint, because I have no way here to click on junk lead or close lead. The lead is still open. Okay, and it's important for the business to apply those specific rules on every employee. So that's the magic of a blueprint. I hope that I was able to explain the blueprint in a good way, because I got many emails from people that saying that they went on online and there was no good information about how a blueprint really works. So hopefully I was able to explain how blueprint works in a real business. And you know, let me know if you have any more questions. I will create more videos. Thanks.